Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to upload files asynchronously in the Blazor File Upload component. I will also show you how to enable chunk and directory uploading. Let me open my existing example, where I've installed the Syncfusion Blazor inputs package. I have already included the file uploader rendering code. With this code, I can upload multiple files and configure save and remove actions to manage the upload process to the server. Let me run this application. Check now, when I upload a file, it will be saved in the root folder. And when I click the clear button, that file will be deleted from the root folder. By default, the uploader processes the files when they are selected and added to queue. To upload the files manually, I need to disable the auto-upload property. Check the output. When I browse and select files, it will be added to the uploader queue. See here, two action buttons, upload and clear, will be displayed in the file upload layout. I can clear a few files if they are not needed, manually upload the others by clicking this button, and clear the list using this button. You can also upload the files sequentially by enabling the sequential upload property. See now, the selected files will be uploaded one after another. Even if a file is uploaded successfully or failed to upload, the next file will be uploaded. Next, I will show you how to display the list of files in Uploader that are already uploaded in the server. First, include the Uploader Files tag and specify each file detail using the Uploader Uploaded Files tag. Specify the name as bug, size as 28,000 bytes, and type as PNG. Check now, the file is configured with uploaded successfully state on Uploader queue. So, I can view the loaded files here and remove the unwanted files from the server by clicking bin icon. Notice here, bug image file is removed in the server. I can also upload a large file by splitting it into small chunks and transfer them to the server. To achieve that, set the custom size 500,000 bytes to the chunk size property. Then I open the sample data controller and add the chunk file parameter in the save action method. And based on the chunk size and file length, the file will be saved in the server. Check now, when a large file is uploaded, it will be split based on the chunk size and saved into the specified path. See here, while processing the uploaded file in the server, the file in the queue has two options, resume and cancel. I click this button to resume and this one to cancel the upload. You can notice the PDF file saved in the root folder. Next, I will show you the additional configuration to modify the chunk upload. By default, if an error occurs while sending chunk request to JavaScript, the operation will be on hold for 500 milliseconds and will retry again. In the upload erasing settings, add the retry after delay property and set the custom value to 3000 milliseconds. Also, retry operation occurs 3 times by default. To customize it, add the retry count property and set its value to 5. So, in case of file upload failure, the provided configuration will work. Here, file uploaded successfully. Next, let's see how to upload all the files in the folder. To do that, I include the directory upload property and set its value to true. I can upload a folder when the auto-upload option is disabled. When I upload a folder, confirmation dialog will be shown to upload. So I've enabled the auto-upload option. Check now, when I browse, only folders will be shown. When I choose the folder, you will get the confirmation to upload all the 3 files in the folder. I will confirm by clicking the upload button. Notice all the 3 files are uploaded successfully. Finally, I will show you how to set the external target element as the drop area. The element can be represented as an HTML element or element's ID. Add the content division element with ID as drop area. Provide the caption as drop files here to upload. Then add the drop area property in the uploader and assign the target's ID. In the style section, I will add a few styles to align custom drop area and uploader component. You can check these styles in the GitHub link in the description below. Check now, when I drag any folder and drop it on a custom target, it will be uploaded. In this video, I have shown you how to upload files asynchronously in the Blazor File Upload component. I also showed you how to enable chunk and directory uploading. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.